Hi, Alex here from Rebeloper.com, and in this video I am going to talk about Siri shortcuts and how you can add your Siri shortcuts into your very own iOS app. So without further ado, let's get started. Okie dokie, so Siri shortcuts, that's a new thing in iOS 12 and today you are going to learn how to add it into your Xcode project. So we are going to build out from scratch an app that generates a random number, interesting, eh? So while we are generating a random number inside our app, we will add Siri shortcuts to our app so you can ask Siri to generate a random number, and once it does, it jumps into our app and of course shows the generated random number. So let's get started. Okay, let's jump into Xcode. We just minimize my test project here and create a new project. Go to File, New and Project. Great, remember you need Xcode 10 for this as it supports iOS 12. So we are going to create a single view application, click on next, and I will call this Siri shortcuts random number. Make sure the Swift is the language of your choice. Click on next, I will just drop it onto my desktop here and I will create a Git repository on my Mac, and of course you can check it out on my GitHub repo too. I will push that up there once we are finished. Okay, let's create this. Okay, let me just move this up a little bit so you may see more clearly. Okay, here we are. At this time we are not going to delete the main storyboard because it's much easier to add these elements. Remember, I always like to code without the storyboards, but in this simple to use app it is okay. I find it very difficult to use storyboards in a more complex app. So what we are going to do here is add a label in the center and the bottom at the bottom of our screen. So let's click on here and let's type in label, and let me just move this a little bit to the left here and simply drag and drop it onto the bottom of the screen. Now let's anchor this horizontally in container and vertically in the container. So let's add these two constraints, and the next up, select the attributes inspector and delete the label, add a zero there, and next up set the size of the label to be 100. Okay, let's click on done. There you go. Next up we will add a button at the bottom of the screen. So button, let's drag and drop that out here, center it. Okay, horizontally in container, add one constraint, and then let's add a bottom constraint. Make sure that constraints to margin and the height of, let's say, 30. Okay, add two constraints, that is great. And let's add for title, and that's it. Now let's connect that into our view controller, with our view controller. Okay. So what we need to do is go to our label, click on control and drag it out. Okay, and that would be, I mean, just name this label because it's not that important. Okay, let's connect that, and this one, control drag the button here and make sure it is an action. It is an action by default. So the name should be, okay, let's connect. Okay, let's connect. Okay, so let's go back and close this assistant editor and go to our view controller. Great, let me just close this off. Now we have our label and our tab button. Now what do we want to do when the button is tabbed? Well, we want to generate, of course, a random number. So let's create a new function here. I will just type it out, generate random number, Great. And let's copy this and create a new function, generate random number. Okay, let me give you a little more space here so you may see. Okay, so in Swift 4.2, a new a new way of generating random numbers is in effect, and that is pretty cool. And let me just type that out. Let's say random number equals, and I will create an integer, so int and a random. And here you can see here we will choose this random in a range, and the range will be between 1 and 100. Great. Next up, we need to add this random number to the label. So label.text equals, and we will add here our random number. Great. Make sure that this is a string, so you need to add that into those parentheses. Okay, and that is it. Let us just select not our iPhone XR, because I have tested it on my XR simulator. Let's test it in the XS. I believe that will be okay. So let's build and run and see if the random generation is ready. Okay, let's wait for it to launch. Till then, I will explain what we are going to do next. Well, we are going to add our Siri shortcuts, but let's test this out. So let's generate random number. Pretty great. We are generating random number between 1 and 100. Good stuff. Okay, now it's part for the fun fact of Siri shortcuts. Now, first thing what you need to do is, of course, enable Siri. So let's go into capabilities and scroll down and enable Siri. So go there and click on, make sure that the steps are okay, checks marks have appeared, so we are good to go. Now let's go back to our view controller and let's add here a new function saying, because we are going to create a new user activity, and that user activity is what the iOS will check upon and make sure if the user activity is pressed, is present a very long time. Let's say we tapped on that button for a long time, let's say 100 times, then in the suggestion there will be this user activity. So let's create this function here. First of all, we need to create a user activity. So, and we need to add an activity type. Now, this is important because this is how the system differentiates between different user activities. So you need to give it a unique user identifier. It is a string. So let's create this as a really good coder. So let's create a new struct. But first of all, for the struct, we are going to create a new file and let's name this. Just copy this for future reference. Let's create this. Let me just drag and drop it under the view controller. So we create a new struct and it will be named user activity type. And I will create here a static let, and let's call this. Now, what should this string be? Well, it is pretty simple. Let's just grab our bundle identifier. com.rebeloper.siri-shortcuts-random-number or whatever it is for you. Let's go back here and give it a dot at the end and add this generate random number. So this will be the unique identifier for that. Let's hit command B so we get a build, and I believe we have, yes, here it is, our placeholder. So let's type in for the activity type now, user activity type, and generate random number. And this way we omit all those occasions for typos. Okay, now let's set up our activity. Well, for first, let's set our title, and that will be a generate random number. I will have those spaces in there. Next up, we need to make this activity eligible for search and predictions. So type in activity is eligible for search equals true. And likewise, activity is eligible for prediction equals true. Great. Now we need to set this activity to the user as the user activity. So self dot user activity equals activity and self dot user activity dot and become current. So this should be the current activity. Let's hit command B and build and run so we see everything succeeded correct. Now one last step is to go into our empty-liget and just set this function. Continue user activity restoration handler and so on. So what we do here is fetch the activity from search, from Siri, and make what we want to do inside our app. And what we are going to do is generate this random number. So let's create here a switch statement, and we have this user activities activity type. Okay, and if this is user activity type generate random number, then we generate the random number. Otherwise, we just print out. Now, what we need to do now is grab our view controller and generate a new number. Okay, so we just let unwrap our view controller. So then we have our view controller. So we may easily generate our random number. And that is it. So we need to still return false here. Great. Now let's go back to view controller and let's add here a print statement. So we may see something in the log too. Okay, and here we go, random number. Now, let's hit command B so we may see that everything builded. Okay, so one last thing before we test this out on our simulator. I don't really know why, but I just found out that you need to create a new scheme. So let's go into manage schemes and let's edit this current scheme. And what you want to do is a duplicate scheme. Okay. Now let's go into manage schemes and select, let's just rename this to, let's say, test of Siri shortcuts random number. And now let's edit this and under executable, so go ahead and select run and info, under executable, set ask to launch. Okay, and now we can close this. Great. Now, as a good touch, we are going to add an app icon so you may see that beautiful app icon. So just go here on the desktop and I already have one. I believe we are ready for testing. So select Siri shortcuts random number and select your preferred simulator and let's build and run. Oh, one thing before we continue, let's add our App Store icon here. So we need this 1024 points app icon. Okay, that is done. Okay, now let's generate a random number. And of course, the more you tap on the number, the more Siri will suggest this. So let's do this a couple of times. Let me show you in the log here. And let me just tap, tap, tap. Five and so on, so on, so on. Okay, now let's go and stop this app and go into our settings. Okay, and scroll down to Siri and you should see your shortcut here, but it isn't there yet. Okay, that is because first of all, you need to enable inside developer mode. So go back and under developer, just scroll down all the way down where till you see display recent shortcuts. Okay, and let's go back to settings, Siri, and let me just build and run again. Tap, tap, tap. Okay, let's test settings, and there you go, generate random number. Now, what you can do now is add a Siri call out for this generate random number. But before I do that, let me just show you how you can now already, you can already search for this shortcut. So if I just swipe all the way to the left and I type in here generate, you can already see Siri shortcuts, cause random number, generate random number. This is the title that you gave, and let me just stop this and give it a more proper name. Okay, and that will be it. Let's build and run again and see if the changes take effect. Well, sometimes in search changes do not really take effect immediately, but if you already had the display name set up, then it would be okay. So let's stop this and let's go simulator and let's search. Okay, let's type in the generator. It didn't really change this, but this should be changed maybe if you edit or delete your app and so on. Okay, now what I wanted to show you here, let's cancel that out, is going to settings, Siri, and now let's create a Siri callout. So generate random number. Great, let's click on done, and here we are, here is our phrase. Great, now whenever you call Siri generate a random number, it will go to your app. Now let me just show you how it works when we search for it, and that will conclude our tutorial for today. So generate, okay, and okay, let's click on this, and here we go, we have generated a random number. Let's go back to search again. Here it is, our next random number. Pretty great. Now that is it for today. Of course you can add many shortcuts, as many shortcuts as you wish to your app, and that is quite easy if you know what you are doing and if you have followed along this tutorial. Now hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go ahead and give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Now I have a pretty serious question for you that you will need to comment down below. What are you going to create with Siri shortcuts? Now, what is your favorite shortcuts? How will you implement these Siri shortcuts into your app? Okay, see you in the comments down below and in the next video as always.